Amen. God bless, guys. My name is Uni Lopez, and you are tuning in to Unified with Christ. Thank you so much for joining us tonight on this beautiful Saturday morning. We just glorify this day with you, Lord, and we had such a wonderful week. Today we celebrated a co-laborer, if you will, on my worship team, Erica, getting a promotion. Praise God. And I just love when we come together in celebration and adoration of our Savior Jesus Christ. And I'm just going to start off with scripture, which is the scripture on which my ministry stands on, which is Psalm 133:1, which is how good and pleasant it is when the brethren dwell together in unity. Amen. I am so pleased and honored to have brethren with me tonight on this special edition of A Night of Comedy and Laughter. I have Marian Michelle with me tonight, as well as Deacon and Chaplain, Dieucel and Mireille Dalturis. Amen. Praise God. And we're just going to fellowship. We're going to talk about a few upcoming events. One in particular, which is the main event, if you will, for the night. It's a night of laughter comedy show, which is going to be upcoming this Saturday, June 7th at 7 p.m. at Central Assembly, which is located at 1300 Eaton Avenue, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, 18-018. And for more information on details or anything like that, you can call 1-917-426-3241. And it's going to be $25 per person or $45 per couple. And we're going to have Ariel Sanabria and Linda Holiday. And I'm sure we'll have more there. And that's going to be hosted by Central Assembly, but be presented by The Gathering Place. Amen. Well, before we start, I'd like to start with a prayer for those that are listening, as well as those that are with us in the studio. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we just love you, Lord. We glorify you, and we thank you, Father God, for giving us breath this morning and every morning, Father God. And we just thank you for this time, this appointed time, for nothing comes as a coincidence to you, my God. And I thank you for each and every person that's listening, as well as each and every person that's in the studio, Lord. Father God, I pray that you will have your way, Father God, that as people listen, that they will not only hear what has to be said, Lord, but that even after the broadcast is over, that you will continue to speak into their lives, Lord, and that you will be a light of hope into someone's life, Father God, that's in complete darkness, and even brighter light for those who know you, Lord. We love you, we honor you, and we pray that you continue to have your way in this show and in everything that we do and in everything that we say, Father God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So first, I want to introduce Marian Michelle. Thank you, Michelle, for coming.
Hi, Uni. Thank you for asking me to come. And this is a delight to be with you here.
Amen. Amen. Well, I know Marian. I know Michelle. She's just so awesome. But for those who don't know who Marian Michelle is, if you would mind just saying a little bit about who you are and the ministry that you're a part of.
God bless everyone out there listening. My name is Marian Michelle, as Uni has already said. And The Gathering Place is a ministry that brings people together from all walks of life. And we do Bible studies each week, mainly with unbelievers. And what we do is we set a foundation and get people ready to accept Christ and understand who the Lord is, and move them on to different churches in the valley. I've already placed like 4 or 5 people in different churches. Out of there has came our missions trips. And we do a missions trip every year to Cuba. And it's also we serve pastors and leaders in Cuba. That's also part of The Gathering Place. And this year, we have the privilege. The Lord has opened doors for us, and we have come together with 2 other ministries so that we can serve the people of Haiti. Mm-hmm. We all know how much need there is in Haiti, and so we are going there, and that is what the comedy show is mainly about, and who is going to serve.
Amen. Amen. So if you're in the Lehigh Valley, particularly in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, on June 7th, you have to come down. I personally know Ariel Sanabria, and he is hilarious. And he is going to bless you. Amen. And Linda Holiday as well. She's a ventriloquist and a magician. Praise God. And God is just so awesome. And I know that he's going to do something amazing. And the one thing that I love in particular about this event is that all of the proceeds will be used to feed and clothe the poor in Haiti. Amen. Because that's what we're here. We're supposed to be the hands and feet of Jesus. Amen. And I'm going to share a point of scripture that you shared with us before we came to the segment, which is where I believe why all the proceeds are going to feed and clothe the poor in Haiti, which is in Matthew 26, 35, which says, "For I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger and you invited me into your home. 36, I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you cared for me. I was in prison and you visited me." See, that's the God that we serve. Amen. That is the God that we serve, that goes out there and feeds the hungry and provides love to those that feel unloved and unnoticed. And that's what's so amazing about the God that we serve. Praise God. And I'm looking forward to being a part of this event, Michelle. I'm excited. I know God is going to do something amazing. And when we come back, we're going to go into a song right now because I like to bring in worship as a worship leader. I love to hear worship just to set the atmosphere. We're going to come back with this amazing man and woman of God. This is Dieucel and Mireille Dalturis. Amen. And we know the God that we serve. He is mighty. He is wonderful. Praise God. So I pray that you will come back and you'll join us after this song. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
Wonderful, merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend. Ooh, what a thought that a lamb could rescue the souls of men. Oh, you rescue the souls of men. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace our hearts always hunger for.
Yes, Lord, you are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. And you are the one that we hunger for more. That is so true. And we want to just thank everyone for tuning in right now. If you're just tuning in for the first time, again, my name is Uni Lopez, and this is Unified with Christ. And just going over an upcoming event that's coming up this Saturday, June 7th at 7 p.m., called A Night of Laughter, and it's a comedy show. You're going to have a wonderful time, and we have the privilege of having Marian Michelle with us, and she just spoke with us a little bit ago, and she's going to come back. And now I have the honor of introducing Dieucel and Mireille Dalturis. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us. I know you had a little bit of a travel to come in here. We're so appreciative and traveling mercies for you making it here tonight. Amen. I just want you to share a little bit for those that are just tuning in that may not know you, and to share your heart about your ministry and what led you to be a part of this event with The Gathering Place.
Well, what really get me is through a mutual desire to serve the Lord. Amen. And to aid our homeland, Haiti, three friends, including me, I decided to have something to help the Haitian community in Haiti. That's why we found Charity International Ministry, which is CIM. I've been an employed cardon for 29 years right now. And I'm graduate from Mana Bible Institute, and also I'm a deacon at the Haitian Evangelical Baptist Church. And when we decide to do this, the test that heaven and orphanage in Haiti, it's because we know as Haitian how many problems that the Haitian in Haiti have. Because they need everything that you can think of that someone need to live. They need everything. And that's why we put together that CIM, Charity International Ministry, to see how we could help our homeland.
Amen.
Because of that, the Lord is, we always be with us, because sometimes we do not know exactly how we are going to pay the rent for the kids. And the Lord sends someone and say, okay, I'm going to make an event for you guys to pay your rent for the year.
Amen.
And Pastor Michelle take the initiative to do that.
Amen.
And I was so happy, the committee, the whole committee was so happy that we do not have to worry about the rent for that year.
Praise God. Amen.
Because of that, Pastor Michelle is an active part of the orphanage, because she's always there for the kids in Haiti. She's not a Haitian, but she cares because of the Lord, what the Lord put on her heart to do for the Haitian, especially the Haitian who are living in Haiti, who have so many needs that we cannot even count how many needs that they have.
Wow. It's funny. I was going over the scripture that we just went, and then as we were going into the segment, the Lord was leading me to another scripture, and it kind of ties in to how you and Michelle, and I'm sure this third ministry, connected. And it says, and God will generously provide all you need. Then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others. As the scriptures say, they share freely and they give freely to the poor. Their good deeds will be remembered forever. And that's in 2 Corinthians 9, 8, and 9. And I was just wondering why God was pulling me to this. And it's just confirmation of what a God that we serve. He knows where you are and meets you right there.
Yes. Yes.
And praise God for that. And I'm just, it's just amazing. I'm thanking you for sharing your ministry, and thankful for Mireille being here. Would you like to share something that's on your heart about the ministry or about the comedy show or just being here?
Well, it is
a blessing to Amen. Be with every one of you. And also my salutation and God blessing to all who are listening via Amen. The airways. May the Lord continue to keep you. And if anyone listening did not take the initiative to accept Christ, just know there is an Almighty Father who's there waiting for you
Amen.
To just make the decision to just come forward, say, Lord, here I am.
Amen.
And God will open his arm and direct you to a church where you can follow. This moment, I have a great happiness and appreciation in my heart, not only for the station, the radio station where I am, for you, your family, for Pastor Miriam and Michelle, and to respond or to be obedient to the calling of God,
Amen.
And to direct them to Haiti. It could have been any other places in need. But like we all know, after 9/11, things got worse.
Oh, yeah.
And sometimes you are trying to see, God, which one could I help? You want to help the ladies, you want to help the men, you want to help the young people and the children are there. But the Lord put the burden towards the kids. And our desire is to take all the children in need, but we know that can't happen. So far, we only try to take the quantity that we are able to give a place to stay, to give them meal to eat, to send them to school, and also to teach them about the Lord, and also try to find out the trade they are more
and gifted,
gifted in that area, to see where that we can guide them so they can become not only a Christian but also somebody who can help themselves and try to also help those who also in need. So to pass on the baton, to keep passing it on. I help you, you help me, and to continue the work of God like we are doing. And also, I thank everyone who not only put and pray for Haiti, who donate to Haiti, who serve Haiti, and who are there to stand by the Haitian people. May the Lord continue to bless everyone. And I encourage all of you, please, be a good good steward of the Lord.
Amen.
Come into the program on June the 7th.
Amen.
And so you can see all of us and we'll be able to shake your hand in person and say thank you.
Amen.
And it was a pleasure to be in the way. And I thank you for inviting us.
Amen.
And may the Lord bless everyone.
Amen. And one thing I got to say about this event that's so, I think, amazing is that you're taking a night of comedy, but in all reality, it's not funny what's going on in Haiti. It's very serious. But we're trying to make a point, I guess, if you will, is we're trying to get people to come together to do something. Because when you don't know, when you're not in Haiti,
yes.
and we can't see what's going on for ourselves, it's hard to picture what it means. We were talking earlier before the show, and we don't even know what it's like to go 4 hours without eating.
Yeah.
You know, we joke in hindsight, maybe we get so busy. That's the only way I'll forget to eat is when I'm busy doing work.
Yes.
But in reality, we got children and adults, elders, that are going not just hours, but days without eating, guys. This is serious. But to take a young man like Ariel Sanabria to come all the way from New York, to come out and support this type of event shows the severity of what is needed in this, not just in this community, but in Haiti. So if you can't personally get out there to a missions trip yourself, just come out and support this event. Even if you can't make it in and you don't live in Bethlehem, call 917-426-3241. I'm sure they got credit card machines that they can take a donation over the phone. Maybe you can't come to this event. Maybe this event will be streamed live and you can tune in. We don't know. But the reality is, it may seem like a lot of money to you $25, but in reality, that is nothing. We'll spend that in a night out in a restaurant, which will probably throw the food away, where in another country like Haiti, $25 can probably go a week, maybe even 2 weeks, to feed families, not just a person. Like, we go to a diner and eat food and feed ourselves for $25 and maybe our spouse. But here, we're looking at feeding families. That is a lot of money to a family that's going to mean more to them than it can ever mean to us. So I pray that this event, you know, just ministers to your heart. And I just thank you all for coming. And if you have anything else that you'd like to share in regards to what's the Lord is putting on your heart.
Well, the other thing I would like to share is the first little boy that we take in Haiti. What makes me so happy, so glad, is 2 years ago I went to Haiti. He called me aside and he told me, "Daddy, I would like to be the director of the orphanage one day." That touched my heart.
No.
Because he sees the necessity of the children. He doesn't worry too much about himself, but he wants to be the leader, a director for the orphanage. I told him, "You could be there. There is nothing wrong with that." I compliment him for that, because he sees exactly what we are doing. Because when you wake up in the morning, you don't know what you're going to eat. It's not a joke. And he was working with his uncle, because they kill his mom,
they
kill his dad, and he was working with his uncle. They could spend long hours walking, looking for something to eat, and it just happened. We just opened, and the uncle came to me and said, "Is there anything that you can do for him, for me? Because we do not have a place to sleep. We do not eat." I told him, "Okay, we will take him for you." And since then, he is with us. And you will have the opportunity
to
give him a hug.
Amen.
To see what I'm talking about. Wow. And it's a blessing, the way the Lord works for us. And it's a blessing for us, for my wife and I, to be here tonight.
Amen.
I did not know you. I did not know your husband. You don't know me. But by the grace of the Lord, we come together for a good reason.
Amen. And a greater cause. It's June 7th, guys. It's at 7 p.m. It's at Central Assembly. And even though it's entitled The Night of Laughter, comedy show, this is serious, guys. We need you to support. We need you to come out. We need you to help Haiti. Okay, this is serious. We're not talking about just having fun, which I know you will. I know that you will. But just think about someone else. Let's think outside the box. You know, when you get up, or even before you go to bed, you're gonna eat something,
mm-hmm.
and that you have the opportunity, even if you're not hungry, that you could. Let's think about somebody else. Let's think about that family. Let's think about that young man that got saved by this beautiful couple. Think about the young men and women that are still in Haiti, that are waiting for a meal. And that meal could be determined by your attendance or by your donation.
Mm-hmm.
So again, if you're just tuning in, the event is on June 7th. Please call 917-426-3241. And Mireille, you said something earlier that touched my heart before we go into a break. You know, if you don't know Jesus, you can come to know him right now.
Mm-hmm.
We may be talking about something, but one thing, it doesn't matter where you are, what you've done. We serve a God that paid the price
yes.
over 2,000 years ago on the cross by taking on our sins, by the lashes on his back. And to know that we are not guilty.
Yes.
And we are now in victory. And if you don't know him, we pray that as you listen to this song, that you will invite him into your heart. And if you don't know how, we will show you. So we just thank you. And join us. We'll be right back. God bless you. This is so true. Amen. Praise God. Thank you for tuning in. If you're just tuning in, my name is Uni Lopez, and this is Unified with Christ. The song we just heard is called Not Guilty by Mandisa, and that song says so much. We think that we're not good enough, and we have a list a mile long, but Jesus says, what are you referring to? Because the list that you're speaking of, I have no idea. Hmm. Because I took your sin.
Amen.
So, and I think if we were to grasp that understanding, people wouldn't feel so condemned and so afraid. Yes. To commit their lives to Christ. I think sometimes some people, and I'm sure you can agree, by leading unbelievers as well as young believers in Bible studies, that they feel that they have to have their life perfect. Mm-hmm. Before they have to stop drinking, they have to stop smoking, they have to stop partying before they can come right with God.
Well, most of them would say, I want to do it, but I'm not ready. Yeah. I haven't finished doing this or that or the other. And you're absolutely correct. We're always thinking that we have to be a certain way. Mm-hmm. And we will all always be short. Mm-hmm. Before God.
Amen.
There is no way that we will ever be perfect before. Mm-hmm. God. And, you know, this is what I teach them, is God has open arms for us all. Amen. The time, all the time. You know, when we fail him, when we fail ourselves, when, you know, God is there to teach us, to grow us, to love us.
And I think that's what it is. When I know I've done it, we've all done it. But when we come to know Christ in the way that we do now, it's understanding that we're not that person anymore.
No.
That person, it says, I believe in 2 Corinthians 5:17, that we're new creatures in Christ.
Yes. Yes.
And people don't understand. I'm still in the same flesh. How am I new? I'm still in the same clothes. I'm still doing the same things. Because it takes time for some people.
Amen.
Some people get saved and literally transformed within the same day, if not within minutes, because the Holy Spirit engulfs them. Mm-hmm. But for other people, it's a process. It doesn't mean that it didn't take effect. So if that's you, if you feel it tugging on your heart and you feel, I don't got my life right, but I'm not good enough to serve the Lord. I still got a lot. I still want to party. I still want to go to the clubs. I still want to do this and that. Just call out on God. The Bible says he asks you to come as you are. It doesn't say come when you're ready. He doesn't say, you know, come after you did everything. No, the Bible says come as you are. And you are forgiven. Once you ask him, God, Father God, forgive me of all that I have done wrong. You are forgiven. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of people, myself included, have given their lives to the Lord. And then they sin, or they do something that's not sitting well in their spirit. And they get the Holy Spirit to convict them.
Mm-hmm.
And then they are, again, here they are, Father God, Father, forgive me, forgive me. Mm-hmm. When you don't realize, and I didn't realize, so I admit this. When you invite Jesus to come into your life, he forgives you of all your sins. Not just what you did before you came to Christ, mm-hmm. but even those that are going to accrue when you're 50, 60, and even if you're lucky, 100 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And longer.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But I just felt like I had to say that, because I'm not sure who's listening. But I thank you for listening. And I thank you for taking time out of your day, whether you're listening to us live right now or whether you're listening as a rebroadcast. It's not by coincidence, because we don't serve a God of coincidence,
mm-hmm.
Father God. We serve a God that's an on-time God.
Amen.
And if you're listening to this message, it's because you're supposed to listen to this message. It's because God has a word for you, whether it's tonight on this broadcast or whether it's at this event that we're talking about tonight, which is a night of laughter comedy show, which is going to be on June 7th at 7 p.m. And it's going to be hosted at Central Assembly of God. Now, Michelle, earlier you said that there's another church or another ministry involved in this event that's coming up.
Yes, I said earlier that we are three ministries doing the work of God. And something that you said earlier, we are the hands and the feet of God. And this,
amen,
is what serving the Lord is about. And it brings me great joy when I can serve other ministries and when other ministries can serve us, because this is all about the work of God. It's all about bringing the souls. It's all about feeding the hungry. It's all about visiting the prisoners and making sure that they have what they need, because that's what God wants us to do, and that's who he wants us to be. We have another ministry that joined us this year. I had me and Dieucel had came together last year, and at the first comedy show, we did it for him alone, but for his ministry, for the children in his ministry. But this year, we have joined Christ Hope Center, and they are in Jacmel, Haiti, and it's Pastor Bonit Afriani. This is a 73-year-old woman who was a registered nurse in New York City, and the Lord said to her, you're going back to Haiti. And she fought the Lord, and she fought the Lord, and she went back to Haiti, because when the Lord sends us, we can't sleep. But she's back in Haiti. She's been there for 10 years, and her ministry serves 250 children a day. She feeds them. And so she also has an orphanage with capacity to for 40 or 50 children, but that's not open yet. But this woman, a great woman of God, has adopted a four-year-old boy. He is now 4 years old. She adopted him when he was a newborn, which was left at her door, almost dying. And because she's a nurse, she brought him back. Anyway, this is the other ministry that we are helping. We do, we partner with them to serve the community and to feed the elderly 7 days a week. And so we're coming together with them to service the elderly, and we will be going to the prison in Haiti. When we're there, we'll be leaving on the 22nd. Yeah. So we're serving the children, we're serving the elderly, and we are serving the prisoners. So as of now, we have been collecting donations for these three people. Well, the elderly, the and we have we are just collecting everything from toothbrushes to soap to shampoos to everything that a person, a human person, may need. And some of us don't understand that we take for granted that every day we have a soap bar and every day we have a toothbrush. But this is not the reality in another country. And so I ask anybody who cannot make it to this event and maybe cannot go, that if you have any donations, you can still call that number. You, if you, the Lord touches you to give, you can still call that number.
Amen. Amen. And as you're speaking, a scripture just came into my mind, and it's 1 Corinthians 1:10, which says, I appeal to you, dear brothers and sisters, by the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, to live in harmony with each other. Let there be no division in the church. Rather, be of one mind, united in thought and purpose. We need to come together, guys. If you're listening, it's not, again, by coincidence. You have to come out. Pastor Dieucel Dalturis shared a little bit of a testimony of what came of the last comedy show that the Gathering Place did, which was last year, that they provided a rent for a whole year. That was last year, guys. You know, we serve a God of abundance, and that does so much more. Ephesians 3:20, we serve a God that can do imagine more than we can ever think or imagine. So let's come together. Let's unite. Let's be on purpose for God and go to this event. Even if it wasn't in your plans, let's make it a part of your plans and just see that if you can just come, and if you can't come, like I said, call 917-426-3241. You just heard a live actual testimony. We're not talking about something that we saw on the TV. We're talking about a young man that I look forward to meeting on June 7th and seeing what God is doing in his life, that he was able to have his life transformed. If an event could be done and it can pay rent in Haiti for 1 year last year, I know that God's going to double that this year. And again, if you cannot come, I appeal to you, I plead with you to call that number and ask, how can you help? How? And it doesn't have to be, yes, it's $25.45. I'm sure if you call with $5, they're going to appreciate that, because that $5 can get toothpaste, it can get toothbrushes, it can get 5 bars of soap. Okay, so don't think, well, I don't have enough to go to the comedy show. Well, why don't you call? Why don't you call that number and tell them your situation? Maybe you only have $10. Well, they can take that, and God will multiply it. Amen. That's the God that we serve. Amen. Okay? So that's what I love about the God that I serve. And I pray that you listening know the God that I serve. And if you don't, I pray that by the end of this broadcast, you will know the God that I serve. Amen. And we love you, Lord. We love you so much. And we thank you, Father God, for joining us, Father God, in this time. Father God, and your Holy Spirit dwelling within us in this time. We love you so much. And I pray that you return so that when we return, we're going to play this next song entitled Jesus, I Love You. And I just let this song minister to you. This is a song that I wrote that I know that when I where you were, I didn't know who Jesus was. Before Christ, I was living for myself. And then when I came to know him, I was only wanting to sing and write about him. Mm-hmm. And then in the third verse, it talks about my wonderful husband. And I pray that you come to know him in an intimate way the way I did. So I just pray that this song ministers to you. And if you don't know him, I pray to God that you will when we come back. God bless you.
Amen.
Chose for me this man to hold my heart.
We do. Praise God. Thank you so much for tuning in. Again, my name is Uni Lopez, and this is Unified with Christ. If you're just tuning in, we're talking about a night of comedy and laughter, which is going to take place on June 7th at 7 p.m. We want to take a moment for those that are listening worldwide, and we're going to make an announcement. I've been announcing it throughout the broadcast, but we want to take a moment for those that are listening in Haiti. And we want to take a moment to announce this upcoming event in Creole as well as in Spanish for those that are listening. So, Deacon Dalturis, if you can do announce in Creole, we would really appreciate that.
Zami, ou même qui chita la ka ou kap koute, c'est un plaisir pour nous avec ou assoué, pour nous faire connaître que gagne yon soirée côté moun pradri pendant toute soirée à moun yon apri, et puis tout l'argent qui ramasse yon pralvo yon en Haïti pour ba ti moun manje, pour ba rad pi yon met sou yon. Pabliye, c'est Ariel Sanabri a kap fête, toi sa ap, et qui le la fête? C'est samedi 7 juin à 7h du soir. Qui côté la fête, c'est dans Centrale Assemblée de Dieu qui chita dans 1300 Eaton Avenue dans Bethlehem, Pennsylvanie. Dans zip code là c'est 18018. Pas oublier n'attendre vin supporter conseil ça son bagage qui essentiel. Et numéro de téléphone pour relé c'est 917 426 3241 917 426 3241. Prix assez seulement $25 par personne. Et puis, si c'est ou même avec Madame Capvini, coupe, c'est $45. Vin supporter et ambiance ça, parce que nous connaissons, ou content pour eux, que c'est toute cobla prade en Haïti pour aider tout le monde qui grand goût, tout le monde qui dans pauvreté, tout le monde qui dans misère. Nous souhaitons qu'autant de nous, que grâce et Père Bon Dieu était avec vous. Bye bye.
Amen. Praise God. And now we're going to have Michelle speak in Spanish to those that are listening.
Marquen sus calendarios. The Gathering Place presenta una noche de comedia y alegría. Todo lo que hagamos en dinero será usada para darle de comer y para comprar ropa para los pobres en Haití. Presentaremos a el comediante Ariel Sanabria. Esto se tomará a cargo el sábado, junio 7 del 2014 a las 7 p.m. Eso es el sábado que viene en la Iglesia Asambleas de Dios Central. 1300 Eaton Avenue en Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Si necesita más información, por favor llame al 917-426-3241. $25 por persona y $45 por pareja. Que Dios los bendiga y espero verlos ahí.
Amen. Amen. And again, one last time, it's a night of laughter comedy show. Again, it's going to be on June 7th at 7 p.m., which is next week already, guys. So if you're not doing anything and you're living in the ABE area, which is Allentown, Bethlehem, and Easton, please, we encourage you and we pray that you join us for a night of laughter. Again, all the proceeds will be used to feed and clothe the poor in Haiti. And we just heard a wonderful testimony, and I'm sure if we had more time, we'd hear more wonderful testimonies of what's taken place with the past events that have been taking place with the proceeds that have gone into Haiti. And I know the God that I serve, and he's going to supply all the needs according to his riches and glory. Amen. And if you don't know him, I pray to God that you come to know him. Mm-hmm. Don't feel that you're too far. You're never too far from God. Mm-hmm. For he created you. He created you in your mother's womb. That's what it says in Psalm 139. He formed you in his image. Mm-hmm. Though we don't look like him, in the natural, because we don't really know what God looks like other than what pictures tell us that he looks like. But he loves you. He loves you so much. It's unconditional on how much he loves you. And there's nothing, absolutely nothing that you can do to stop his love.
Amen.
Other than blaspheming him. And then that's something completely different. But if you are eager and you're feeling a heartbeat out of your chest and you're just feeling chills and you're just feeling something that you've never felt before, that's Jesus knocking at your heart saying, let me in. And it says in Revelations 3:20, here I am, I stand at the door and I am waiting for you to let me in. And I always share this analogy of the picture of Jesus in the picture of Revelations 3:20. If you ever took a good look at that picture, if you ever look at the door, there is no doorknob. It's just an empty, it's a door. But he doesn't walk into your life. He doesn't say, here, look at what I did on the cross. It's a door, but he wants you to let him in.
Amen.
And we have to say, God, forgive me. Forgive me for what I've done. You don't have to be perfect. We already said that, because he's perfect. You don't have to do everything right, because he did everything right over 2,000 years ago. And the word of God says in Romans 10, 9, it says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is by believing in your heart that you are made right with God. And it is by confessing with your mouth that you are saved. Amen. Amen. So I don't care where you are. I don't care where you were. I know where you are now and you're listening to this broadcast. And again, it is not by coincidence. So I pray that as we come to a close, we're going to pray. We're going to pray the sinner's prayer, and anything last words that we have from Michelle or Dieucel or Mireille, they can share. But I speak to your spirit right now. I speak to I speak beyond the person. I speak to that spirit that lives within you, that desperately needs Jesus. You've tried everything else. You've tried possibly drinking. You're still back to where you are. You've tried partying. You're still back to where you are. Try Jesus. You will not be disappointed. You have people who will pray with you. You can email me at unilopez@soulwinners.org. You can message me on Facebook, Uni Lopez. You could join the Unified with Christ page. We'll pray with you. We'll walk with you. And most importantly, he will walk with you. So I just pray that the Holy Spirit speaks to you even after this broadcast is off the air. He is always on and he's always listening. So I pray that you will cry out to him and say, Jesus, come into my life. Amen.
Amen.
Do you have any last words?
But the last word that I have, I would like to repeat again in verse 35 of Matthew. He said, for I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you invite me in. I need clothes and you clothe me. I was sick and you look after me. And I was in prison and you came to visit me. And then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did you see me hungry and feed you, thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you, stranger, and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When you did, we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you. The king replied, I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did it for me.
Amen. Amen. Mireille, would you like to share your last words?
I thank everyone for listening and hope that I will see all of you. And don't let your opposition stand on the way of your blessing, accept our proposition so you can get your blessing. Hope to see you soon.
Amen.
And be blessed.
Michelle.
I just want to remind all our friends that are listening, those who are not serving the Lord, those who are struggling, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He loves you. He's there. He's caring for you, and he has you alive. And while there is breath, there is hope. Call on him. Thank you.
Amen. And again, if you confess with your mouth, I'm going to read the scripture again. If you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe with your heart, you will be saved. And if you don't know how to cry out to him, just repeat these words. Father God, I know that I'm a sinner. Father God, I know that you are a God of forgiveness. And I ask that you come into my life. I believe that you died on the cross and rose on the third day. And I believe that you died for me. Father God, forgive me of all my sins. Clean me righteous before you. Show me how to live for you in all that I say and in all that I do. And I ask that your Holy Spirit come within me and dwell within me and show me and give me the desire to learn and hunger more for your word. And I ask all of this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Well, thank you so much for tuning in. Join us next week. Well, our next guest will be Pastor Miriam Rodriguez. She'll be joining me on June 13th, I believe, which is the following week after the show. 15th. If I'm not, is it the, let me see. Let me look. 15th. I want to make sure that you join us. So please, join us, and I know that you will not be disappointed. So again, that's next Saturday on June 14th. Again, we love you, we honor you, and we glorify you, God. And thank you so much for tuning in to Uni Lopez and Unify with Christ. God bless.